So this started out for me as a little bit of a puzzle. I was involved in some research to help moms reduce tobacco use and prevent exposure of their infants to tobacco smoke. And we realized that mothers, even if they stopped smoking and their children were not exposed to tobacco smoke, they ended up showing signs of tobacco smoke exposure in their urines, and we couldn't figure out why. Eventually, we realized that we need to follow the tobacco smoke. There's a huge mass of various compounds that are being released, and you can think of it as a coating that covers everything it gets in touch with. And the compounds that stick around are compounds that we know have profound impacts on the human physiology and with potentially significant health outcomes.
The exposure we're looking at is related to the residue left by tobacco smoke on dust and surfaces in the home. It's called third-hand smoke. Children are likely most exposed to this because they have behaviors where they crawl on the floor, they put their hands in their mouth, they touch things, and so they absorb things through their skin. And so they're very at risk for anything in house dust or surfaces. So this is the high volume surface sampler vacuum. So one of the concerns with third-hand smoke is that these compounds, such as nicotine, can actually react with air pollution, such as nitrous oxide that comes from gas stoves or from traffic, and create really toxic tobacco-specific nitrosamines, or TSNAs, that are some of the most toxic and mutagenic compounds known. So they can actually increase toxicity over time. So what we have in here are some of our third-hand smoke samples.
They turn out to be ubiquitous. They turn out to be extremely persistent. We know that people get exposed to it. How can we get rid of it? And that is really the $5 million question. Because of its complexity, because of its many different compounds and the different properties of these different compounds, this is going to be a complicated task.
There's not a lot of guidelines for what to do if you find it or how to have your home tested. We have recently received a grant from HUD, from Housing and Urban Development, to determine if certain forms of cleaning are effective in making a home less contaminated.
We don't want to use any toxic cleaning agents. We want to test more green products, more environmental friendly. So we'll see, you know, how the regular cleaning method will get rid of the third-hand smoke.
One of our goals is to really help educate smokers as well as non-smokers of the consequences so that people are aware of the legacy that they leave behind, especially in an environment where more and more non-smokers really appreciate breathing clean air and not exposing themselves to known carcinogens and other toxicants. I think this will become a more important issue over the years.